Dear students, in this lecture video, we studied about the definition of unit commitment problem, introduction to unit commitment, and a need for unit commitment. All the three topics comes under third part of the module 1. The third part is nothing but unit commitment. So, in this lecture video, we detailed studied these three topics, that is definition, introduction, and the need of unit commitment. The first one is the definition of unit commitment. Unit means generator. Unit means generator. And then commitment means to meet our load demand. That means to commit a generating unit is to turn it on service. That is definition of unit commitment problem. That is to bring the unit up to speed, synchronize it to the power system, that is interconnected power system, and connected it so it can deliver power to the network. Okay, so this is the definition of unit commitment problem. Then next, introduction to unit commitment. Because the human activity follows cycles, or most systems supplying services to a large population will experience cycles. So therefore, it includes transportation systems, communication system, as well as electric power systems also. Suppose in case of electric power system, the total load on the power system will generally be higher during the daytime and the early evening. When the industrial loads are high, the lights are on and etc. So the early evening, the industry, that means the loads are lower during the late evening. Okay, so that means on the daytime, early evening the load is high, late evening the load is low. You know, because early evening the industrial loads are high. Okay, and then similarly the early morning when most of the population is asleep, so therefore the load is low only. Now what is the need for unit commitment? We can explain with example only. Now you see the example. I am taking three units, unit 1, unit 2, and then unit 3. Okay, in the unit 1, the minimum generation is 150 megawatt, maximum generation is 600 megawatt. The unit 2, minimum is 100 megawatt, maximum is 400 megawatt. For unit 3, the minimum generation 50 megawatt, maximum is 200 megawatts. The H1, H2, H3 is nothing but the cost, that is the production cost. Okay, then the fuel cost for the unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, 1.1, 1.0, 1.2, that is the price rupees bar mega Britain, BT mean Britain units. Okay, now, okay, you see, in this case, our load demand is 550 megawatt. That means what unit or the combination of unit only should be used to supply this 550 megawatt economically. Okay, how to solve this problems? First we have to make the combination. What are the possible combination of all the three units? First we have to prepare. You see the tabular column. This is unit 1, okay, unit 2, unit 3. The formula is 2 power, actually, here 3 units used. So, therefore, 2 power n means 2 power 3. That is how many combination? 8 combination. In the logic design line, you studied, no, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, and then 1, 0, 0. 101 110 111. So this 8 combination, 2 power 3 mean 8 combination is there, possible combination. So that's why here we are writing respective unit of that means unit 1, unit 2, unit 3. The maximum generation based on here what all the three units are opposition. So therefore minimum and maximum generation both are zero. Therefore this is nothing but the infeasible solution. Okay, then the second combination is 001. In the 001, the maximum generation is 200, the minimum generation 50 generation, but this is not meet our load demand 550 megawatt. So therefore this is also infeasible solution. The third combination is 101, that is off on. The maximum is 400, the minimum is 100. So therefore this combination also is not possible to commit our load demand 550 megawatt. So this is also infeasible solution. The remaining five combinations meet our load demand. You see 600 600 800 1000 1200. So the 550 in the five combination only, so therefore meet. So first you write unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, the combinations, then you can write on the maximum generation and then minimum generation. P1, P2, P3 is nothing but the production cost. Some formula is there. Based on the formula, you can fill this one. And then F1, F2 is nothing but the fuel cost. The sum of these three fuel costs is called as a total generation cost only. So like that, you have to prepare the unit combination and dispatch for 550 megawatt. In this tabular column, very important thing is that means the combinations and then dispatch of the load only. Okay, then second, that means suppose only the running the most economic unit, the load can be supplied by that unit operating closer to its best efficiency only. But suppose one unit is breakdown, means another unit is committed to meet our load demand, and because all the units are synchronized. Okay, now you see the peak valley load pattern load curve. This is the daily load curve only. You see that means the minimum load is 500 megawatt, maximum load is 1200 megawatt. The time from 4 p.m. to next to 4 p.m. that is the time of the day. You see, based on the load utilized by the consumer, this is the shape of the curve like this. From the load curve, we have to find this is the base load, this is the maximum load. Base load is 500 megawatt, and then minimum, the base load is 500 megawatt, maximum load is 1000 megawatt. Okay, now the same thing we got to based on the shutdown rule. Okay, for example, 101 means what? Unit 1 is, that is on, off, on. Apa unit 1 is on, unit 3 is on, but unit 2 is off. Okay, so like this. So in this case, that means you can how based on the shutdown rule scheduling, you can see this is the, here is the minimum is 600. Minimum is 600 megawatt, maximum is 1200. You see, this full portion is nothing but the unit 1. Okay, when the unit 1 is, that means up to 600 megawatts, that is the unit 1. Okay, then 600, then to some 1000 megawatt like this only, the unit 2 only. Then the above up to 1200, the unit 3. So therefore, the shaded portion, that is based on the shutdown rule only, we should identify for which period the unit is on service, the remaining is shutdown. Okay, then this the curve from the figure 1 and B, that means 1A and 1B, and all the operation of the system is optimized, means the unit must be shut down as the load goes down and is recommitted as it goes back up only. Okay, that means this problem that means is far from the trivial when the real generating units are considered. Okay, so then second, the same example only, but here the minimum demand is 500 megawatt, the maximum demand is 1200 megawatts. Now we prepare the வாட் ஷட்டவுன் ரூல். நவு வி ப்ரிப்பேர் தி ஷட்டவுன் ரூல். ஷட்டவுன் ரூல் வி ஹவ் டு ப்ரிப்பேர் ஃபார் த எக்ஸாம்பிள். சேம் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஒன் ஒன்லி. த மினிமம் இஸ் 50, த சாரி 500, த மேக்ஸிமம் இஸ் 1200 த லோடு. த ஸ்டெப்ஸ் இன் தி இன் ஸ்டெப்ஸ் ஆஃப் 50 மெகாவாட் ஒன்லி. தட் மீன்ஸ் 500, 550, 600, 650, like this. So here unit 1, unit 2, unit 3. Okay, now we prepare the shutdown or rule. Okay, so these are the shutdown rule. You see, at the all the combination, the unit 1 is on. Okay, from the curve only. Then, unit 2, that means up to 600 off, up to 600 off, above 600 only, megawatt only, the unit 2 is in service to commit our load demand. You see the unit 3, that means first 4 up to 1050 only. So then less than 1050, the unit 3 is shut down. The remaining 2 units only, that is share our load demand only. So the based on the shutdown rule only, we can easily, then we can identify the which unit is on service to commit our load demand only. Okay. Then you can take another one more example is the two region system. One is western region, another one is eastern region. So the two region system consists of 5 units and then the maximum demand is 3090 megawatt only. And then the 550 megawatt only in the either direction of the that means what? In the either direction only 550 megawatt. That means the transfer. Okay, then between the two regions through die lines, the power transfer is 550 megawatt either from left to right or right to left only. Okay, now you see the diagram, two region diagram. This is the western region. The western region consists of 3 units, 1, 2, 3. The eastern region consists of 4 and 5. You see, I told, no, in either direction, either from western region to eastern region or eastern region to western region, the transfer is 550 megawatt only maximum, not more than 550 megawatt based on the concept. Then now we prepare the generation, maximum generation, minimum generation, how generate the what is the generation of each unit? What is the spinning reserve? What is the regional load and power generation? How much power interchanged between the western and the eastern? First combination only western region. Then second combination. The second combination is the eastern region. The third one is the total. Western means 1, 2, 3. And then eastern means 4 and 5. Total means 1 to 5. Okay, based on the rating, western region 1800, 800. This is the unit capacity. Eastern region 1200, 600. Total is the 4400. Okay, what is the output of the generating unit 1? Actually, the rating of the unit 1 is 1000. But how much output we are getting from unit 1? Only 900 megawatt. So the 1000 minus 900, that is equal to 100. This control 100 megawatt only is called as the spinning reserve. Like that we have to make the and then find the spinning reserve of unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, unit 5 and then the combination of 1 to 5. What is the maximum load? That means 3090. Okay. So therefore in the western region 160 megawatt in the eastern region 160 megawatt out only. So from the tabular column, you can easily understood the unit capacity of all the 5 units, unit output. And then what is the regional generation? Regional generation, that means the actual output of, that is the sum of the actual output of the all the generating units which are placed in the western region 3. And then eastern region 2. So therefore this is the total. This is nothing but the regional generation in megawatt. And then spinning reserve is nothing but the unit capacity minus unit output. We are getting spinning reserve. So the regional load, only. Okay. So the regional load. So here you see 1740 only, but the interchange is 160 only. So therefore the 160 plus 1740, we are getting 1900 is nothing but the regional load. Similarly, 1350 plus 160, that is equal to 1190, that one thing only. And then 390 only, that is the 3090 only. Dear student, from this lecture video, you can clearly understand the definition of unit commitment, introduction to unit commitment, and then the need of unit commitment with examples. Okay. Thank you, students, for listening this video.